Shebeen King!
Shebeen Kings!
Welcome to another next episode of the Shebeen Kings, and thank you so much for your support for the past couple of months.
Yeah, we thank you. We thank you.
It's been a ride.
Yeah, see right.
It's a ride.
See right.
See la. And of course, we don't go by ourselves. We've got the whole team behind the building and behind the scenes.
Yeah, drum roll.
I Fintan in the house.
I Fintan again. Thank you, Fintan, man. The guy behind the scenes.
My day.
Yes, thank you so much to I Fintan. And of course, I don't walk by myself. I've got the one, the DJ, the one who does the one and twos.
A DJ, a D-Cinema.
DJ Woody, she say,
guys, was good. Big up to all the fans out there. Shebeen Kings, we love you. Chukushimaya, we're here. We're outside.
To my fans.
Hey. My fans are ego. They're there. Only if you got one or two. I'm trying to like your chitter. You know, that's the thing. I think after today's episode, right? And we're gonna have a lot of people who listen to us, you know. I reckon. I'm being a little bit cocky, but I reckon.
My fans are.
Yeah, my fans are. But to respect all fans, yes. You know, you subscribe.
Yeah.
You know, you gotta follow for notifications if you wanna see the alert notification and post something, because we've got to one when I say, go post like exclusive all.
Sanas.
That's kind of like exclusive. So here we have someone, you know.
Okay.
Right. In the city, there's a guan going on. Apparently, we have a big show coming up of award winning.
Okay.
I think this year has won 6 awards from Nama and the Zimmer as well, right? Nutty O, the boy. AKA Ability Extension. And then we also got the legend, man. The guy who's been in the game for longer than 20 years, man. So, this guy has been here for a short time. This guy has been here for a long time. And that's our respected brother, ExQ.
Yes, Mr. Pujit.
And I should go meet him, Papa. Hans Panichi, Panumano, Selector Manzi. Probably lost tracks you hear on this mom radio, actually produced by him. And this is DJ Tamuka. So, yeah, this show is on the 8th of October, apparently, in Cologne. And tickets are going for €25. But it's your my tickets, because price that you're going to say, I'm going to make my price. We're going to talk about that. That's the whole point. But anyway, before I get into too much into the issue, I think let's introduce our lovely guest. And that is the we're going to hear more about this story. But apparently the man behind Afro Heist, we're bringing the lovely artist to Germany. So yeah, we're going to find out. Anesu, welcome to Shebeen, man. How are you doing?
Thank you for having me, guys.
Yay!
Oyo.
Oyo. Bapindira.
Welcome, Shebeen. You good?
I'm good. Thank you for having me, guys.
No. Okay, so we outside.
Outside.
Why are we outside, Eno? Wait, why are we outside? You know, like, so this summer, wait, before we go on, Anesu and Eno.
Yes.
This summer we had a lot of events going on.
Yeah.
Especially in NRW, I think all over Germany, and the 9-year tickets, right?
Yeah.
So people, you know, could go wherever. Which events did you guys attend? Maybe let's start. You know, like, what event did you attend? Did that you enjoyed a lot?
It was, the summer was dope. I really enjoyed it. Like, yeah. I would shout out to my guys, 4x100.
4x1.
You know yourselves. You know yourselves.
Respect to the guys.
I was pretty late. There, but it was pretty nice.
So better late than never, as they say, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
But I think one of the highlights was a Berlin show, the Mapiano, the Focalistic show, and
the piano wave is killing it. Hey, like it's totally like taking over Europe.
And Devin Gogo was good. It's quite sad that I didn't make it to Summer Jam. Mm. I didn't make it to Afro Nation. I really wanted to go there, but I had a good time. Like my piano one in Berlin, and that was a vibe. Thank you so much to all the guys who came to Berlin. Thank you for making my summer.
And this is for you, man. Like, which summer events you say, okay, you know, you actually really enjoyed the summer?
Yeah, the same one, 4x100.
Yeah.
It was a nice event, I was there. It's just that most of my summer was in Zim.
Okay.
Yeah, but I think that's the only one I went to.
Okay.
I hear the Zim Euro event in Osnabrück was also nice.
Yeah.
Shout out to them for having a nice event. But yeah, those are the only ones I went because I was in Zimbabwe most of the time.
No, all good. I haven't been a party person summer. Summer's been about work, it's a grind. But I attended two events. First of all, Suero Connection with Audrey.
Oh,
she was
dope.
A guest here as well.
Yeah,
I really, really enjoyed that one. I think that one was really nice to do something different for a while. And big up to Suero Connection. And Audrey and the team. And also, the one I heard lots about was Afro Vibrations. Our first guest, that was Kosi. Afro Vibrations, the boat parties, man. That's so, so cool, so dope.
The Sunset Cruise.
So, yeah, Afro Vibrations, big up to you, man. They're growing. They had their first festival. You know, like when Kosi was in the Shebeen?
Yes.
And she said something big was coming. Okay. And it actually came the summer, which is the festival.
Okay.
When she had a boom, I don't know, is it Bunapa? The South African DJ.
Okay.
It was really, really big festival. So big up to Afro Vibration, the team. That's Nkosi, DJ Friga, DJ Kaju. Big up to you guys. You guys, we see you guys growing. They've actually got a party coming up as well. I think it's 30 September. So if the boat cruise is your vibe around Cologne, then please enter. I'm not sure the tickets out. There's still out tickets. I think they're actually all sold out. But yeah, so just check. I think there's an after party. You can check and then you can then visit the event.
We'll see.
But that's the size of summer so far, you know. But we've actually got a current issue that's burning right now, right? And that's why you got Anesu here. Anesu.
That's the one.
Who is Afro Heist and what is Afro Heist?
Oh, okay. So, yeah, Afro Heist. Entertainment group or company, you want to put it.
Yeah.
And we've got big plans for people in Germany and Europe. We'll be focused in Germany and Poland. Maybe in the future, Netherlands, Belgium, you never know, we'll get there.
Okay.
So
are you focused on a certain genre? Or for you, is that the plan? Is it to focus? Okay, I know, like for example, Afrobeats, it's Afro beats, Amapiano, Kom, what else, Kiduro, and stuff like that. So, do you guys have certain genres you kind of focus on?
We are about African music, not necessarily anything, but what we want is to support mainly the Zimbabwean artists, you know, bring them to the European market. Introduce them to the Europeans,
because
we want our artists to be international, you know. Mainly is to support our Zim artists. That's the plan.
That's the plan. So Afro Heist is all about supporting African artists, but African mainly artists. Right now also with the lot of local artists like from Zimbabwe as well.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Put it that way. So you have this first party coming up. So this first party has, like I said, mentioned before, Nutty O, ExQ, Tamuka. How does the process go of picking these artists? Do you just randomly pick? Are there suggestions from people, or it's just about who's available?
Okay, so this is the first event for Afro Heist, so we couldn't reach out to people necessarily to say which people do you want to see?
Yeah.
So it was out of our discretion, like, which artist could, you know, bring people to a first event. Because, you know, a first event is always hard to do, you know, because you don't know what people like.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't know the vibes. You don't know the numbers of people who pull up and stuff. So we really wanted a very good artist, which people appreciate. And yes, that's why we came up with Nutty O and ExQ. Mm-hmm. As for the new school, Nutty O is doing very well.
Yeah, he's actually got a track. He's actually in the Fire Emoji remix. And that song,
Fire Emoji.
Like, I think they actually got a release coming out soon. Yes. So of the Fire Emoji track. It's gonna be banging.
It was banging on that track. I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it.
So you say that you got Nutty O, he's doing well in the new school.
Yeah.
And then DJ Tamuka.
DJ Tamuka. You know all the hits right now.
Yeah.
You know he's the one that produces them.
Yeah, I think also produced the Mustard Seed album as well with Nutty O. Yeah.
So well, when I reached out to ExQ.
Yeah.
Yes.
Shout out to ExQ. He's a legend.
Yeah.
It was kind of his request also to have Nutty O to be, they call them selectors, you know, the guy who select the music.
So,
did he say that really?
Yeah. I was like, why not this Tamuka? Come on.
of course.
Tamuka. So, yeah, so that's why we have XQ, Nutty O, and Tamuka. And many more artists are going to come, guys. Be on the lookout. Want to bring the vibes, you know, to Germany. We're always singing in the UK.
Yeah, so listen, if you look at the lineup, right, you have artists like Nutty O, XQ, D Tamuka. They're all staying in Harare, I'm guessing, right? So what's happened to other places? Like, we also got, you know, people from Bluweo, Mutare, Gweru, Chinoi, Kariba, Chipinge, etc., you know? So what? So did you actually approach any artists from these other places? Or
Gwanda.
Yeah, or Gwanda as well. Gwanda or Pinga.
Okay, so I'll say, like, first of all, like, Harare, well, when it comes to music, Harare is, like, the main place, yeah? But I actually reached out to my friends of mine. I was like, who stay in Bulawayo? I'm like, give me what? Do you know if a good artist from Bulawayo?
Yeah.
But they seem someone, most of them actually, they said, one of them was like, the one I liked passed away, I guess, Kelvin.
Question, I mean, you're from Bulawayo, you know, right? Which artist is actually Bulawayo? Like, as in, I want to know
right
who's
now, on the spot,
who's hot,
spot
right now.
Drop. Who's hot? Who is available? Who is here right now? Our QA.
You got Hour in Germany, Hour. Actually. So when, what did you approach Hour?
Hour's in Germany, right?
Yeah, yeah. She's in Germany. Right?
Yeah. Okay. So Hour QA, I reached out to on Instagram.
Okay.
But there was no response. So I guess maybe the way I reached out to her.
So there's no response. Like not even like in seeing your message or replying.
No, so she blue ticked you.
I don't know if she saw the message, but I guess for the next show, maybe I'll use email. Maybe that's better for her.
Okay.
Maybe she wants it to be more professional. I guess that's what she wanted. So, yeah, for the next
show. I mean, you just say, please, if you have a query, just go to my email address, it's easy. But anyway, all good. But big up to Hour, wherever you are, Hour. Big up to you. We see what you're doing.
She's actually
a new brand ambassador for Chibuku.
International review.
She actually got the endorsement. So yeah, big up to Hour. We love what you're doing. The girl from Kai.
Enkai.
Nice stuff. She's from Bremen, I think.
Yeah.
Shout out to yourself.
Shout out to yourself, Hour. Yeah. So you asked Hour, or you sent a query to Hour. Did you send out to any other artists, or you want to talk about the names today?
From Bulawayo, you mean?
From Bulawayo. Anyone else?
The thing is, like you asked, you know, you just told you one.
Okay, so who else is hot in Bulawayo?
Hot. The thing is, to be honest, hot right now, I wouldn't put a name on anyone else besides what I just mentioned. Because I feel, coming from Bulawayo, I feel like everyone from Bulawayo is basically shifting towards South African vibe.
The Afro.
The Cubsers, the Uncle Waffles, everyone going on there. And correct me if I'm wrong, there's probably someone out there who's good.
Uh-huh.
But if they are going to pull a lot of people, it's going to be quite tricky.
I've seen a popular character like in the Zim Dancer arena. Actually, what's his name?
Manine.
But I mean, would Manai bring people out, Anesu, like from your survey, your analyze?
That's the thing. So, if I ask which Manai songs you know, you probably know the one with Enzo. So
yes,
it's really tricky, you know. Yeah. So
yeah, because I mean, these guys have to perform.
How, you know, the one with Enzo.
I mean, like, they have to perform for how long? Like, how long is the performance going to be? Like, with the artists you're bringing, roughly?
Like 4 to 5 minutes to 1 hour.
Okay.
So yeah, you have to think about, because you know you're bringing someone from Zimbabwe.
You're flying them over, the tickets.
You can't just fly visas, someone you know, to see one song. So yeah, we need someone who perform for an hour.
Okay.
So yeah, in the future you never know, someone might come up.
Sandra Ndebele.
Or Sandra Ndebele.
Sandra Ndebele.
Why not? Yeah.
One of those outdoor festivals.
Yes.
Yeah, well, outdoor festival. Yeah, true. Yeah. But anyway, in the future, this is just the start.
Yeah.
If you have a favorite Zim artist or whatever, everyone's going to see their favorite Zim artist, because that's the plan.
Ah, nice. Because in my favorite
job. But things, you see, you know, I have a question, bro. Or not a question, but like a statement. You have a long card. Like, it's just not ExQ, Nutty O, and Tamuka coming. Yeah, there's a lot of DJs as well. Yeah. And also performers from Zimbabweans here in Germany as well, right? Yeah. And I think a majority of them are actually from Blue. Like, if you look at, for example, E-Hash, Tenjiwe, Tip Tac, they're gonna perform before, right? And also, they're gonna perform.
Yeah, those are the, like, they're opening for the
artists, okay.
And these guys are like, they're the Blawayo vibe.
Okay.
Yeah, also DJ Saint as well.
It's well represented at the end of the day, so.
We also got DJ Unrated coming from Switzerland, but he's from Mutare. He actually knows Fenton really well.
Oh.
DJ Underrated.
Shout out to
Malonizo.
I didn't know Malo.
I'm a huge fan.
Underrated, eh?
I didn't know he's called Underrated.
What was he called before?
Malo.
Malo.
Ah, but that's
but degenerated. I'm
Malonizo.
Malonizo, yeah.
But for me, I mean, it was Malo because, yeah, we're like brothers. You know, I used to sing with Malo's cousin's mom.
Okay.
Like, church stuff in the studio.
Okay.
She pizza, your mom church your
pizza. Like, yeah, when these sheds and the my songs in him book.
So what about Dala? What about Dala Gavitza?
Yeah, for real, bro. But Malo, give thanks to Malo and Tindai Mapanga, the cousin. They used to stay together in Hospital Hill. Yeah, in the Reflection Studios, if you remember.
Yeah.
So Malo was in the Chekachin. You remember Reflection Studios?
Yeah, Reflection.
DJ Malo also got another podcast as well called Dissidents. Saga, big up to Malo. We will see you at the Nutty O show.
Yes.
So I'm talking. Right, so there's white card. Like, I mean, so Mutai is represented, Bulawayo is represented.
Sotobe, shout out to those guys.
So why are we talking about Bulawayo in this
one? Everyone is well represented.
Everyone is well represented. I'm not represented.
Where are you from?
Me, I want Tami. I want Tamimo to come.
Is
Tamimo representing?
Is Tamimo from Blue?
Yeah, but she's from...
You're not the only one with the crush on Tami. I think next show we need Tami.
Tami.
I promise all the guys...
If you're watching this, you know what it is.
Tami, yeah.
Chagufundirachit.
But I think for a start, it's a really good thing to just to have...
Yes.
You know, because, I mean, looking at it on my side...
Yeah.
Nutty O, XQ, and DJ Tamuka have worked together.
Yeah, they've all worked together. Like, they work together
I'm sure the workflow is going to be diamond, I tell you. It's going to be
dope.
Because, you know, because sometimes, yes, you bring somebody from there and there, then maybe they don't really...
Like, mix.
...gel with the vibe. Because, you know, you know what it is when you go for shows, you know... You
get the vibe needs to be correct,
sound DJ, it's just... It's chaos.
So I think we're comfortable tonight, but there's actually a burning issue, you know.
Because the thing is now, personally coming from outside.
Yeah.
When I saw the flyer from the onset, then I was like, what's going on now? Because we're like 40 euros. I was like, guys, because we've got Bina Boy.
How much is Bena Boy? Did you go to Bena Boy?
I went, it was 50 something.
Yeah, you see, pretty much the same difference.
But these are three artists coming from Zimbabwe, right?
Well, anyway, if you put into perspective, like if you went to the Bena Boy show,
yeah,
if you see how many people are there, you know, like, for you to have a cheaper ticket, you need more people.
So for you guys, how many people can you actually have at the event?
So that's the thing. Like I said, this is the first event, and you really don't know, or you really don't know what's going to come.
Okay.
But anyway, shout out to Masham Netsi.
Mm-hmm.
He's sponsoring the event now.
Oh, yeah, that's big. So he doesn't, on that point right now, he's talking about the price.
Yeah.
And the price before was actually 40 euros.
Yeah.
And now it's
25.
Just 25.
Yeah.
What happened to change? Like, what happened? I saw an announcement on your page that said that you have a sponsor now, and that's Macho Munetsi.
Yeah.
It's one football player based in France.
Yeah.
What's with that? Please explain to us the what happened there.
Well, so with Macho, like I said, the thing is to support, you know,
local artists.
Local artists and that. But you know, for Macho, is he really wants everyone to come. Because I was just talking to him and I was just like, you know, most people are like, 40, you know, people, 40 euros. And Marshall, you know, Marshall's like, you know what? He wants everyone to be there.
Yeah, okay.
And for him, he also wants, you know, he wants to bring the what people do in the UK. That's his vision, you know.
Okay, so like at festivals and stuff like that, Zimfest.
Zimfest.
Things like that, okay.
He also wants to have that in Europe.
Yeah.
So for him, there's a point of, first of all, promoting local artists from Zimbabwe, as well as giving back maybe to the Zimbabwean community based here in Europe, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
So, yeah, we thank Marshall for what he's doing. So, he really wants
big
to
up
give
to Marshall.
Back.
So, yeah, Marshall Mneti, big up to you.
Shout out to yourself.
You know, there's actually a game coming up soon with PSG. So, if you're out there, apparently, we might have some tickets for you if you do the right thing.
Yeah, if you're lucky enough, you go see Messi play Marshall.
Quick, man, like, I want to be lucky enough.
So what do you have to do? What do you have to do?
Let's be lucky.
If you're lucky enough. That's all I have to say.
I was born lucky. So I think I'm one of those people going to France.
So hint it, nudge. If you, first of all, buy a ticket, then maybe. Into international. That's the first step, right?
Yeah, but anyway, buy a ticket.
Yes.
Promote the event.
Okay.
And
you might be lucky.
You might be lucky.
Might be lucky
to witness Munetsi versus Messi.
Messi
versus
Mbappe.
So because straight after the event,
yes,
we're gonna sleep a little bit. Then you go to France to watch the PSG game on the Sunday. Ooh. So
will the artists be there?
You never know. So I'll just say.
Sunday, 9th October.
Hey, I'm looking forward to that one.
So, be on the lookout. Be on the lookout.
Mandy Ulog.
Aren't you guys having the show on the 8th October?
Yes, so we don't sleep.
And we don't rest.
Sunday evening.
You don't rest.
Sunday evening when rhymes.
When rhymes, watching PSG.
Yes.
Because it's not far rhymes from me. It's like 2 hours or something. So.
Okay.
Rennes, France, so it's his home game.
Yeah.
Versus PSG, so
so if it's his home game, Shebeen Kings, you're honored to have three tickets.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. For three tickets for the Shebeen Kings.
So Shebeen Kings will be
thank
there.
Thank you so much.
Direct.
We'll be there according to your direction. Thank you so much.
maybe, you know, Shebeen Kings, you guys know how to do these things, you know, like on the event. At the entrance, you know, doing interviews of people coming
in.
Oh, that's an invite.
Why not? So Shebeen Kings
will be there at the
event. Afro Heist is here.
Yeah.
And this is official, guys. This is happening.
I think this is actually special. We're actually now the official media partners.
Yes.
Of Afro Heist.
Let's
for
go.
The Nutty O, ExQ, Tamuka Showcase.
Why not?
Shebeen
Why not?
Yo!
Looking forward to it. Shout out to
Shebeen Kings. Shout out to Shebeen.
One thing I'd like for Afro Heist to just clarify right now, because personally, you know, I want to be in the VIP because I don't have been a VIP in my life. I want to be part of the ones. I don't want to grab my couch. I don't know. No, no, no. What is it?
So VIP was Mario. Like, VIP was Mario.
What's going on?
VIP is only 60 euros. So, what comes with the VIP? You know, there are tables. There are tables for 8 people, 12 for 12. So, it's better when you have your friends than just buy collectively. Or you can buy your ticket and you can ask me, which people are in the VIP? So that you can sit with them if you have special people you want to sit with. It's up to you, but it comes with a bottle, it comes with drinks for 60 euros. That's just
So the drink is any drink you want, or how's the range with the drinks?
Well, there's a list of bottles.
Yeah.
Maybe let me get my phone to
yeah, I'm not going to listen to my
attention.
Are we still talking about the soccer thing, or we are talking about the event?
We're talking about the VIP event.
VIP.
So 60 per person or 60 per table?
60 per person.
Per person.
On a table.
On a table. So like, a penny, it would be a list of VIP, right? If you got your friends, you would tell Anesu that, or Afro Heist that, I want to sit with this person and this person and this person.
So yeah. Each of them pays $60.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because this is plus entrance, you know. So your entrance plus the VIP.
Okay.
So, if you are 8 or if you are 12 or if you are 6 and say you... But anyway, like I said,
yes,
you can just buy your VIP ticket. Mm. And if you have people you want to sit with, you can just contact us.
Okay.
Then we put you on a table with these people.
So these tickets are limited. They're limited, right?
They're limited, yeah.
Okay, so like, do you want to say the number or you know when the time is about to get there?
Yeah, they're limited and they're running out because yesterday 2 tables went, you know, yeah, so... Make sure you get your VIP. But anyway, the bottles which are coming with the table, you just choose which one you want.
Mm-hmm.
Vodka Smirnoff.
Vodka Smirnoff.
Red Bull or Coke, whatever. Grey, no. Jack Daniels.
Mm-hmm.
Jägermeister.
Mm-hmm.
Jim Beam, Johnny Walker.
Johnny Fambo.
Takeria, Jim. But if you're a special request...
I have a question.
Mm.
In question, I'm about
that. Yeah, if it's, I know if it's just going to say.
Let's say in the next book, I'm a Zimbabwean. This is like...
A session book.
Yeah. So, that boy is in the 60s book.
60? Ah, no poor day.
I know, no, no. I don't know. Could not change some viceroy and stuff like that.
What's viceroy?
Viceroy.
Don't you think it's good also to promote those people who are doing that?
Yes, this is a question. Are you open for any? I think at that point, Fred is asking, are you open for any collaboration in terms of selling food, but drinks,
food,
Germany is very strict with those rules. Exactly. Yeah, 100%.
So I'm just talking about drinks.
Like, drinks. It's just on drinks point.
I've got 150 Zambezi.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. But, for the first event, yeah, we didn't, you know, the venue, to say, is in charge of the drinks and stuff. So,
because
in the future, that's the plan. Because there are people who also reached out to me about the food.
Mm.
But for this event, it's hard to do that.
Okay, because it's a club.
Yeah, kind of that vibe and stuff. So, in the future, yeah, because that's the plan. We need to support everyone, you know. We're all Zimbabweans, and if you make it, I make it. But anyway, the next event, this is just the first, and it was hard for me to get a venue because ideally we wanted a venue, we're in charge of everything and stuff, but it was hard, and you kind of get those. We got this venue last minute.
Okay.
So, for this event, we won't be able to do that. But like I said,
the future, then something.
There are so many events. December, there's something coming up.
Get December.
For those who are saying, we want this artist, on the day of the event, we're going to have like a survey of some sort.
So, like a kind of voter.
Yeah, like a voting, like we want to have this artist.
Preparation of 2023 elections. So if you're home in Zimbabwe right now, remember to register to vote. So, but to go to a session, because I'm going to vote next year. Yeah,
and you want to register to vote.
Mm-hmm.
And then 2023, guy.
But anyway, like Ines is saying that we're going to be voting at the venue.
Yeah.
for the next artist for December period or whenever next the next show is.
Tell me more.
Okay. One vote. Tell me more. Actually, one vote. Two votes.
One.
In AF Kitchen. Do you also want Tell Me More there?
Yeah, but yeah, that's the plan. Everyone, we won't, you know.
Yeah.
This is just. We're in 2022. I don't know when we'll die, 24th to 25th.
Yeah.
After that, we'll take Tiriko and everyone's gonna see the artist. Everyone's gonna enjoy it.
Everyone's gonna enjoy it.
So, Tiriko is now 25 euros, right? Yeah. But what are people getting for the 25 euros? Like, isn't like, what's the basic experience?
So, this experience is a concert plus party, you know?
Ish. So this party is going on from what time to what time?
Well, we start at 9 and finish at 6, so that's like 9 hours of entertainment.
So 9 hours for 25 euros.
No, that's really nothing if you think about it.
You know, Metzango is a bit off right
now. Talk to me.
You know, maybe if you intermin. Mean, you know, fine.
Talk to me.
25 euros divided by 9 hours. What you get? Maybe, and it's Metzango, I don't
Tabuka. Two point something.
Fine. Let's say worst case, 3 euros.
3 euros.
So you're paying 3 euros per hour.
Per hour.
Pour 35. Hey, pizza.
As
you're paying 2 hours for entertainment. For 9 hours. Kuga, 9 hours. Ndangonzwa Nutty O and ExQ.
Yeah, you can do that. But anyway, your ticket is covered as the party.
Yeah.
But if you want the concert only, because we're going to start with the concert, then move to the party.
Move to the after party.
Okay. Yeah, so if you're just there for Nutty O and ExQ, you can go home. But
that's 2 hours of quality performance.
Yeah.
So Yeah, man, I mean,
But I'm looking forward to this. This is something I'm looking forward to. And
definitely hot.
Let me know. After party, because I'm a person who just goes all in. I'm a person who goes all in. I think we mentioned this, but I want to know. I don't go after party, then I would like his.
Who can I expect to the DJs? Like, who's hot?
The fire on the beat?
So there's one. It's called DJ Kivo Santana from the UK.
Oh, Kivo.
Shout out to Kivo.
Okay.
We have DJ Sane or Sane.
She's a DJ Sane. I heard that one. She's on the radio.
Yeah, she calls herself Sane.
DJ Sane.
Well, she's been on German radio and stuff. She's doing big things.
She's doing insane things.
She's called DJ Insane from now. So DJ Insane.
She's doing some insane things.
But yeah, Sane, big up to you.
Yeah. We have Soto Bay. She's been doing good here in NRV.
She goes to a lot of parties. She's always playing, always.
Whenever I go to a party, I enjoy the music. She knows how
Soto Bay, your transitions.
She knows how to vibe with the crowd.
Your transitions are crazy. Have you seen how you transition from one song to the next?
Okay.
It's like, it's clean. It's like, it's like,
clean job.
We also have Underrated, you know, DJ from Switzerland. That one will bring the, you know, the Zim ghetto vibe. Zim dancer vibe, you know.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, yeah.
It's a mixed bag.
You know, we have the
Amapiano
piano watch, you have the dancer. We also have Ras DJ. From Sweden.
Sweden?
Also dancer vibe.
It was like a kid. I mean, you have piano, you have Zim dancer, you have Afro beats.
Yeah.
So I guess everyone's going to be covered. There's going to be a lot of entertainment, and that's the whole point of the night, right?
Yeah. I'm a huge Afro beats fan. I'll be up there. I'll be going on for the Sukba, Pina Boy. Like, I'm an Afro beats, so whoever is there, I'll be vibing.
Vibes.
Thing for sure.
This is a cool MC you got, you know, like, I'm actually curious about it because I want to hear this from you before we actually bring the Shebeen.
Okay.
But we got Chitoxicated. Also known as Tapata Chito Queen, though. Like, I know mainly from rugby.
Yeah.
But he's an MC that night.
Yeah, you know, if you know Chito, you know, he's all about vibes. He's always enjoying himself.
Vibes, so
vibe engineer.
If you come set, you know, to the event, let's say you're going to break up with your person or whatever before the event.
Yeah,
he's going to get you in the mood to party. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. People who know Chitos, you know,
you can go back to your ex after this.
But big up to Chito Quindo.
Yes.
Man, you know, we love what you're doing. He will be the Shebeen King soon. Although I've heard that he doesn't drink, so apparently he still vibes.
Everyone is inviting the Shebeen.
He's like me, we don't drink, but we're naturally high.
But the vibe.
Naturally high.
What are you drinking?
Drinking
a name I won't mention because they're gonna pay us.
They're gonna pay us. Yes. But let him drink.
Okay.
I'll be a fool to go back.
You know, you're gonna give the. Peter wants to drink. Fidurumwe, what are you drinking?
You know my drink.
This is the drink finished. No mentions.
And yeah, they need to pay us for this. Before we give them the drink, they need to pay us for this. Ino, what are you having?
Pretty much the same thing Finn is having.
Okay, so Ino's a...
Pretty much the same thing Finn is having, okay, cool, actually. Man. So,
we're
keeping it clean. We're keeping it...
Nah, guys, I need to also fill up as well, but what I'm having
fill
is...
Fill up the tables.
Kibiza... Sorry, bro.
As Poonzi.
We need a drink.
So, in the Shebeen we've got today, Glenfiddich.
Yeah.
You're on the 15 years.
Single malt scotch whiskey. Yeah. Is in 15 years. It's quite okay.
15 for the right age.
For the right age.
If her age ain't on the clock, then she's.
But you know what? I'm looking forward to this. This is like one thing I've been looking forward to for a long time. I'm a huge Nutty O fan personally. I enjoy that guy's music. I enjoy that guy's vibes. And I've been, since I heard of this idea, which I really appreciate the idea of you guys coming up with this. I was so excited about this show, and like I said, looking forward to it. Looking forward to the partying, the clubbing, the afterwards, the after party. Do I get to meet the guys? Is there like a meet and greet or something like that? Do I get to like?
If I'm VIP, do I get to meet them?
Yeah, buy your VIP tickets.
So I only get to see the guys in VIP.
You'll see them on stage, yeah. You'll be close enough, but yeah, if you want to meet and greet via your VIP ticket.
Okay.
And yeah, if you, I don't know, if you bring all your friends, you never know, you might go with them to watch the PSG game.
So guys, so we got the exclusive again here, Shebeen King.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mugatinga ma VIP tickets. So when you buy, if you buy VIP tickets, first of all, you're probably in close proximity to the artist, number one. Number two, you might be lucky enough to go to watch the PSG game.
You never know. You never know.
By the way, big up to Amplifier Festival.
Oh, yeah, big up to Prod Marco. We had Prod Marco the other time.
Yes.
Vincent's Craig over there.
I heard it was crazy.
It was dope. The festival.
It was dope. They really did a great job.
Amplifier.
Big up to Prod Marco there with Amplifier Fest. It was a blast, man.
It's a shame we couldn't go to Zimbabwe for that, but...
I was watching online, so I actually bought a ticket through Gateway Music Streams, and big up, I saw Andres, the vocalist, amazing kid, man, amazing talent.
Yeah.
Maybe Anesu, man, sooner we bring him to Germany, you never know.
Yeah.
He is doing something with DJ Mapolis and stuff. He's got talent, the kid. I've seen him.
Yeah,
so in the future, you never know. He might come also.
And Afro, I saw you.
He's the future.
They've got eyes on you. They're watching you.
Yeah.
So you never know.
Buy
your ticket to Germany.
Germany.
So, on this night in Cologne, right? Why did you? Are we gonna have enough security? So are we gonna have like enough security? What's the security status? Because some people might be afraid to get mugged or whatever. I don't know.
Yeah. First of all, fix your relationship. The venue is offering three security guards.
Okay.
Russian guys. So Putin's cousin. So you don't want to.
Hey, my brother.
Hey, my brother. I'm telling you now, huh?
Don't mess around with me.
We also have some Zimbabwean guys, especially for the artists.
Yes.
We have Jones. Shout out to Jones.
Shout out to Jones. The one only Jones. Hey, we can't leave the portal. Give a shout out to Jones.
Jones
is one of our own.
If you have seen Jones, you don't want to be messing around the artists.
The one, the only, the Jews.
Yeah, but yeah, security will be, it will be, I just hope people don't fight and...
So no fighting since the night for jabulating, enjoying each other. If you have problems with
each other.
Yeah.
If you are single, you know, at least live with five numbers. You know, it's all about vibes.
Let it jump by. It's just 30 pounds. Let it jump by.
All good. Yes.
But it's all good. This is going to be a toast.
Toast?
Toast.
To one of the biggest shows coming up in Germany.
Yeah.
Buy your tickets, as you heard. What can we expect from Afro Heist in the coming years? We're looking forward to this.
So Afro Heist is gonna bring you vibes, guys. It's gonna give you vibes to the German scene, you know.
We're
tired of seeing UK people enjoying. So guys, like, a lot is gonna happen, guys. I'm telling you,
big things are coming.
Afro Heist is gonna bring you vibes,
big things, and that in it,
you know. I've been hearing people also want sports, you know.
Sports, 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 sports,
Zim, you like. And yeah, incorporate also South Africans.
Okay.
For our people, because our people love South Africans.
So this is a SADC movement, SADC.
Yeah, SADC. You never know, Mozambique also. We'll bring them. All of them. Even V from Botswana. You have a look out.
That's gonna be a vibe. I'm looking forward to this one. This is one of the biggest shows this year, and summer is not over.
Summer is not over, guys.
Not over, but
this summer was fun. This summer was fun.
Summer was vibes. It was absolute vibes from the start to the finish, and we appreciate that. So to all the Zimbabwean promoters out there doing their thing.
Yeah.
Big up respect to you.
Just on the
promoters, like, are you in partnership with any promoters, or are you working with anyone else behind the scenes? I've heard a lot of people saying that, oh, you know, why is doing so low? Maybe you would like to join and team up so you can do something bigger.
I'm
sorry to interject.
Yeah.
For those who always wait for other people to do stuff and want to join, please, this is not your...
Hold on, panic pressure. Hold on.
If you do your thing, I do my thing, then we see, oh, you did that thing before.
Yes,
yeah.
That's why, even for an example, if you try to engage with, like, Winky D's management, for example, I'm sure they would ask you if you've done...
Actually, I reached out to Winky D, and that was the same thing they told me.
So
yeah. They don't just
this, enough of this people waiting for other people to do stuff and join.
Yeah.
You know, let everybody do their movement.
Yeah.
Then you wait a movement. Yeah. Go.
I will meet you at the river.
Yeah. But anyway, there's so many entertainment groups here in Germany. I know. 4x100, shout out to them. McFano.
Yeah.
Shout out to them.
McFano Hanover.
Yeah.
Hanover.
Press and love, my king.
Press and love, McFano.
We also have Soweto Connection. Audrey. Yeah. Shout out to Audrey.
Audrey, yes. Of course.
So there are so many entertainment. But what I would say is, you know, people should do, like, if Afro Heist does a thing, we support. If Soweto Connection does something, we support. So at the end of the day,
we all support each other.
Yeah, and we have so many things going on, and we all have fun, you know. And so I tried, like, if you see the DJs and the people performing, I tried to make sure everyone.
So everyone's involved.
Everyone is involved, you know, because it's all about, you know, being in the same place and enjoying. But all I can say is, people shouldn't compete.
Yeah.
Because. For you to be successful, your own people have to support you, you know?
Yeah.
So if we compete and if we fight, you will never go anywhere. So all I can say is, let's support each other. Let's be there for you, you know?
On that point, you know.
Wise words.
You see that Facebook post? I mean, I was in the group. I was not supposed to be in the group. It's a ladies in Schengen group on Facebook.
Okay.
There was a post posted. But before we talk about this, I think this toast.
Because what's going on?
No, you lost?
I would like to say, just before we go there, wise words. Thank you so much. Those are very, very wise words. Support is very important right now. And there's not a lot of Zimbabweans in Germany. And we need as much support as we can get. So whatever someone does, let's just back them up. And we at the end of the day, we're all Zimbabweans. And we appreciate everyone who comes and supports us as well. So yeah. Let's go for the Facebook post. I'm lost. Fit me in.
Okay, fine. So, first of all, I see a post. I think she had 9 points. Fine. I'm sorry. Listen, I think before I say this, I just make a disclaimer, right?
Okay.
I have no personal problem with you. I just had a personal problem with the words you chose.
Okay.
And to put on a platform like that, you know, that's something you probably could have probably... Did you get any approach from this lady, like, personally?
Well, I was just giving the screenshots.
Okay, okay, no, so, so before you go on... you didn't approach the Afro Heist
gang
personally. So for me, as I found it a bit disingenuous. But anyway, I think we'll debate about the topics, right?
Well, but anyway, to say to her, well, I saw she then posted, I guess yesterday or something, saying she's now coming and everyone she knows will
come. Okay, all right.
Because the ticket price now is cheaper.
Oh, so that was the issue.
I guess the issue for her was the ticket price. But anyway,
but let's discuss the points, because I mean, I think she had what Ina would deem necessary or maybe worthy comments or like points, right?
Yes.
Ino, you read that post. Right?
I read it. Actually,
which points for you were like, okay, fine, this could make sense?
So what happened was, when she mentioned these are not the points of being internationally recognized as artists,
mm-hmm.
and pretty much being charged the same price as you would charge internationally recognized.
I would say...
What's your response to that?
I would say internationally is someone who performs out of Zimbabwe.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That makes you internationally recognized. It doesn't matter if they're Zimbabweans. In UK.
Yeah.
You're not performing in Zimbabwe.
You're performing in the UK.
Yeah, you're having an international show. Okay. So at the end of the day, you may put it as performing to Zimbabweans.
Mm.
But I'm pretty sure whenever we have a show, you are going to go with your German friends. You are going to go with your Zambian friends. It's not going to just be performing to Zimbabweans. And as a people, we are the ones who make our people international, you know?
100%.
If you push their music, if you push them, then they become international. I'll tell you, Nutty O.
Zimbabwean artists all over, whether UK, if a Zimbabwean artist is coming, don't just invite Zimbabwean friends. Invite the Irish, the Romanians,
the
Deutsch. People can actually experience your culture as well, right? Because, I mean, we always watch their artists here.
Mm-hmm.
So why not invite them to see what we where we come from as well?
You want to say something about
things. It's just like, you know, I talk of Dr. Thomas Mapfumo for an example. He's a person who can perform in the USA, maybe in Ontario, where there are only white people, and those white people, they come and see him, and people are enjoying.
Yeah.
So no matter color, even if we're not going for the first time, then for me, you've broke through good Unzi international artists.
Yeah.
Because sometimes, you know, yes, we support our artists. They come kunyika imwe silinyika, then we say they are international artists. But to end up basketball court, right? Let's say to end up a music bunga by $10 pindai. Magazara boys the kumbare the granora the chishishi and it, but all those people, one of my friends, my Romanians or
so people from different places, yeah.
Bring them in, Ona, so that you know our music is not just. I mean, just imagine I go to Penny or Reve, I hear Master KG's song play in Reve here in Germany.
Jerusalem,
you know. The white people are loving that. You're like, okay, that's what I
call it. But that's because someone like from South Africa actually played that song for someone, and someone's like, oh, wow, this is actually lovely to listen to.
Right? So, outside of the box and to really think, okay, as an international, what are we talking about here?
Mm-hmm.
Let me sing Shona and still a German can feel the
can vibe to that, yeah.
Because in Indoterra house sometimes, like I listen to house or
piano maybe sometimes. Piano,
sometimes. But I don't know what they're singing about, but I still feel it. You know what I mean? But I don't know what they're talking about.
Enough.
The same way as me as a singer-songwriter, I go on the stage, I perform to some other people, they sit down, they pay their money, and I'm like,
Mumbo's a router. KKKS hear me. Yeah.
You get what I'm trying to say? So, my artists in Asango, Jerongo, the Abos, Nango Baya, but they also have to have that engagement with the locals.
Go on and go on with the post. And, you know, I respect to her, wherever she is. yeah, everyone still have their own opinion. But I think, you know, in the future, people should approach people directly and get a direct response before you go on a public platform. But like I said, we're all entitled to our own opinion. So, you know, man, I mean, we spoke about a lot about the event, right? But I think we need to wrap it up. So let me start to go. As you go, you got a lot of meetings and stuff right now going on, right?
With busy man. Events.
yeah. Phone call after phone call.
The streets are busy.
The streets are wild.
They're wild.
Yeah. No, but all good. But so thanks so much for the coming, Shebeen.
Thank you so much.
You know, man.
Yes.
For you, like, are you going to be at the event? I mean, I'm asking, like, are you, if you weren't a Shebeen King,
yes,
would you go to the event?
Hans B day or B square.
Hans B day or B circle.
No, I would have been at this event. Like I said, I'm a huge Nutty O fan. Tamuka,
Nutty O the boy.
ExQ. But I'll be there pretty much. Nutty O. Nutty O outside. At Piri Power.
Because
bless my also days. I've been there, so I'll be there. I don't know if you'll be there fully. Like,
no, for me, I'm right there. Right there.
You see that?
Right there. I'm not even wasting my time.
Yes.
I bought my tickets.
Yeesh.
And I'm ready to go. And this can confirm. Have I bought my tickets?
Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah, you saw it. So I take my tickets. Like, let's go. So yeah, so wherever you are, so just a reminder before we go. Saturday, 8 October.
Yeah.
Cologne. The address, you can check that. I think it's Rolshoverstr 384. If I'm not correct, but we'll just check on the flyer. We're gonna put the flyer right now. So while you're seeing this, you probably see the flyer. So Saturday, 8 October, Nutty O, ExQ, DJ Tamuka, live in Germany for the first time, right? And you're paying €25. And from what I hear, the tickets aren't gonna be sold at the door. So make sure you get your ticket way before. And avoid disappointment, because also I think we have limited space, right?
Yeah, it's limited space. I won't say how many people, but it's limited space.
Make sure you get your ticket, because I don't know the chairman's with the Dumbro ticket. Get your ticket as soon as possible, and that's going to be in Cologne. And yeah, we're going to have a blast, 9 hours of entertainment. Yeah, there's going to be a lovely night. Anesu, last words about this event.
Guys, you don't want to see on Instagram stories, you know, and people having fun. Yeah, it's going to be nice.
Yeah.
It's going to be well organized, I'll tell you that. And yeah, we're going to have fun. So make sure you come, make sure you pull through. And you never know, you might see Messi also, like I said.
Hey, Messi. PSG will be in Reims of the night before. So shout out to
Marshall Manetsu.
Big up to
big things here in Europe.
Yeah.
And yeah, I saw a post, people ask, yeah, is Marshall made it?
Just support the cause.
See you guys there. We're going to have fun. Yeah.
Okay. So that's the last word from Mr. Anesu.
Appreciate that.
The man behind Afro Heist.
Let's go.
So yeah, big up to you. And we will also be following Shebeen Kings over
there. Big up to yourself, man. Looking forward to it. Hey, Shebeen Kings signing out right now.
We are
good enough. Let's go.
Yo.